There's no sun up in the sky. Stormy weather.
Turned up there at the venue, weighed in, you know, where was John Tuck at? Fucking broke his little fingernail, you know. I don't know where it's all coming from that I'm dodging John Tuck because there's absolutely no chance this guy's getting past me. He's going to pay the price once come next week in Manchester. I'm going to come at this guy, I'm going to make a mess and make him pay. And he'll see that he's not going to be there after the first minute, you know, so. Good luck to him.
So it's time to leave you a preview so you two can review what we do. 20 years in this business, how you sell soul, she wins. People bear witness. Thank you for letting us be ourselves. So don't mind me if I repeat myself. These simple lines be good for your health to keep them crime rhymes on the shelf. Live, love life like you just don't care. 5,000 leaders never scared. Rain and noise is the moment they feared. Get up, still a beautiful idea. Get up, throw your hands in the air. Get up, there's sure no fear.
But the reason why I really want to put this dude away is because like I like to finish fights, you know, and my last few fights kind of went to the decision, you know. And that's not the way I like to roll, you know. My fighter fights, I didn't feel right in the ultimate fighter, you know. I still got to the finale, I still won it, but I knew I was capable of more. And the way I like to win is by finishing my opponents, you know. So I nearly had my last opponent away, but he was tough, he was resilient, and he stuck in there, so. And then John Tuck, you know, I was meant to fight him, and now it just keeps building up inside. People saying, oh, you can't finish fights, and I said, we'll see about this, so I'm going to come out and finish him. You know, he let me down the first time, you know, he never arrived, so he's going to pay the price for that. He's going to wish after this fight he had a fought me the first time, you know, because I'm going to be so hard on him. I'm going to put him away within two rounds, you know. He'll probably try and jump guard, do all these like jiu-jitsu stuff, but you know, I'm prepared for wherever the fight goes, you know. I feel like I'm the more equipped fighter in this fight, you know. It's not like back in the day where you can just be one-dimensional and take the guy to the ground or wrestle him, you know, or you can just be a strike, you know. I feel like he's more one-dimensional. Well, he's got some striking as well, but I'm more technical striker. My wrestling's stronger, and I'm good on the ground as well, you know. I know that's his stronger area of his game, but I feel I'm the better mixed martial artist in this fight. And I'm going to pressure him. He's going to punch into the thin air, you know, and then he's just going to be hit with dust. I don't need anything to get me motivated. I'm motivated every day, you know. When I wake up in the morning, all that, don't matter if it's raining, it don't matter if the sun's spitting out the sky. I just need to go to the toilet, take a good look in the mirror, and that's it. That's my motivation right there. I'm ready to train every day, all day, every day, you know. But you know, it does suck whenever you've got this miserable rain in your face every day here back home. It's a lot different from the California sun, you know. I was thinking about going there for a year, you know, but I don't know if I could do it. Like, it's you know, I'm a family man at heart, you know, and I've got a girl as well, you know, and I wanted her to come out as well, but it's going to be hard just to go away for the full year. I don't mind going out there and doing my fight camps 100%, definitely. I'll go out there 5-6 weeks at a time, do my fight camp, and come back. It's always good to come back home before the fight, you know, get to see my people and see my family, my girl, everyone else, you know, all my teammates. But I don't know, I don't think I would move there permanently.
Fuck, big cheese and a weller from Cali, eh? Now my girl, she's gonna come down here and cook this chicken for us, you know? Cause I ain't got time for this shit.
6 years, I think I've cooked for him a total of 4 times.
You what? It's been a while since I cooked, you know, everything was done. What? Fuck! Jesus fuck, we're gonna blow the place up! What was I gonna say? Olive oil, that'll do the trick.
I usually use coconut oil when I was in America, but fuck it. This is what we're using.
No? It's low fat, Parlays. No? So.
I'm gonna edit these videos.
What do you like? Big portions, medium or small?
Grande.
Fucking can't cook, won't cook. Put this in your book, fucking Gordon Ramsay, cunt.